Hello, my Juicy Co-creators. Lilou here. I'm in Amsterdam today on a Juicy Living tour with Paul, the Greek Paul. Hello.
Thank you. Welcome to Amsterdam. You brought the sunshine, you see. Sun is here.
Thank you for doing this interview on a bed. How funny.
It's a beautiful place to be with. You came, so this is what I produce. Off we go.
Yes, you make beds, and I'm really excited to have this conversation because you do what you do with so much love and creativity, and this offers great solution and inspiration, I think, to the world and to Greek people watching, of course, because you're Greek yourself, and then you immigrate to Holland a long time ago, or?
No, I'm here for a year because my son is playing football here. Next year I might be going, you know, to another country. I follow my son's career. Uh-huh. So, and I make mattresses and beds and shops wherever he goes. It's a good opportunity, it's a good chance for me to start a new shop. Uh-huh. And it's a good excuse to say to my wife, we have to follow our son, so we go there.
Yeah. I just love, and I want to thank Ivo for connecting us. Ivo that wrote The Spirit in Finance, because there is truly here, we could feel that you do it from the love, and it's not so mechanical as we usually see in the traditional business, but you do it. Tell us how all this came about and how you have created this business and the reason why you have created this business, because to me it doesn't seem like you have created to make money, but you're being highly successful in many ways.
It was 89 back in Greece, and I went there with my wife, and I was a professor teaching, you know, and money wasn't enough, so I should do something in the afternoons in order to be able to pay the rent and all this stuff, the expenses. So I started working in Plaka, where, you know, Plaka? Plaka is a place where all the tourists go to see Acropolis, and I started working in a shop selling gold and all these souvenirs. So, and then somebody passed by, and he bought a lot of stuff, and I invited him to show him the Greek hospitality. And although the shop wasn't mine, I said, please come and we enjoy a beautiful dinner with our wives. We went there, and then he asked me, do you know any place where I can buy mattresses? And I said, mattresses? No, I don't. Because he had a shop in Holland selling mattresses, which he was buying from Germany. He thought I might get some mattresses, better quality and cheaper in Greece. Anyway, I took him to a place where I knew nothing about, but I had bought just a mattress. And then he said, yes, but it's not exactly what I'm looking for. It's not the quality. But this guy there, he told me, could you help me export? Because he found a good product, what he was producing. I took his product. I came here to Holland, but I couldn't sell because the quality was very low. But I'm very impulsive. And then I saw some pillows. And then with all the money I had, 15,000 euros at that time, it was all my savings for a year almost. And then I said, I buy these pillows. I brought them down to Greece. I didn't know what to do. I had no company. I had no place to put the pillows. So we were swimming with my wife in a small apartment we had in between pillows. And then I went back to him and I said, listen, stop what you are doing. You're not producing something that Europe or the world would buy. And then we start producing with a zipper around. You work for me from now on. And because I'm not good with my hands, but I know what we should be offering to Europe and to the world. And we start producing something very transparent because we've got a very bad fame abroad that we don't do what we say, Greeks, no? So all our products will be with a zipper around, number one. Second, we produce mattresses made out of seaweed, of cocoa fiber, of wool, cotton. No springs, because springs is not a good product, according to me. Because all these years from history, prehistoric also, but history, has been sleeping on non-metal beds, like Plato, Aristoteles, Socrates, all these people. If you read, you see that they were sleeping on wool, on seaweed, on cotton. So that was the main reason that I wanted to make a product that was based on tradition, non-metal, and on transparency, without any zipper. And little by little, we started producing. Nowadays, we are around the world, and we are very happy. Are you sleeping, by the way, on COCO-MAT? Do you sleep on COCO-MAT?
No.
Right now, I'm sitting on COCO-MAT.
That's why you are sleeping, but I have to convince you to enjoy a COCO-MAT bed. And that's why I invite you to Greece to check first. This is what we're doing. Let the customers know the quality of our beds. And this is also a nice policy, a nice tradition we have, that let the customer know exactly what we are doing, and then if he wants, he can buy it. We have hotels around the world, and we do that.
I'm really excited because it seems like things have been just flowing in a quite natural way and one thing led to the next. And that's why I think it's inspirational. But also because this is the crisis and you're thriving. This is an example, too, of what is possible during this time.
We have to define the word crisis, first of all. It's a Greek word, by the way, no? And the definition says crisis is the noun. And the verb, which is not used, means that I'm going to evaluate the situation, more or less. So we have to evaluate the situation nowadays more than years before. And I think it's a natural mechanism of nature that makes people think twice. Mm-hmm. Because there is no crisis. I don't see any sort of lack of tomatoes, of food, of bread or anything. For me, crisis is among people. You owe me this money, I owe you this money. Have you seen any standard of living going down? I don't think so. It's going up, but not down. What I mean is that nowadays you go to a kiosk in Greece, buy your luxury car to buy cigarettes and make yourself, you know, very unhealthy. Whereas with a crisis, you will not think of getting your car, but you will get your bike, which we are already producing in Greece, and I'm very proud of that, a new factory producing bikes. And then the crisis leads you to a very healthy way, since you are going to think twice about the petrol, twice about the cars. So I don't think that the crisis is the proper definition that everybody has in his head. That means crisis means lack of products, lack of food in general. When you think in a primitive way, crisis is that I cannot have enough to eat. But this is not what's going on around the world right now. Everybody has got something to eat, apart from places like Africa where there is no water. But in Europe, what sort of a crisis are we talking about? We can do exactly the same things without the products, without the means that we have right now, or we used to have, like cars, like air conditioners, like whatever. Mm-hmm.
I love your idea of using seaweed, for example, and using what nature is not rejecting, but just naturally giving us.
Giving you. Yeah. The sea gives you seaweed. Long time ago, all the houses in Greece, not long time ago, 60, 50 years ago, were made out of seaweed, the isolation and also the walls, part of the walls. So imagine all these people from, you know, from Socrates, I go back, Plato, 300 years before Christ, up to now, they use the same way of living. Seaweed, you know, hay or whatever. And they used to have beds and mattresses, non-metal. All of a sudden now we go and we change that. Okay, it's good. I'm not against technology. It's very good to progress and do stuff. But don't misuse it because it's going to be against you.
And no patterns, you don't really have patterns either, patterns.
Yes. No, because I think there are no secrets in life. If you fall in love with me and I fall in love with you, it's because you are different, not because you are a woman only. Because some details on you, they are different than others. So exactly the same with the product. The product is there, you can see that. But details, who is going to use, let's say, seaweed? You have to go yourself. To make seaweed, to dry it, to get it, to put in your company, to teach people how to do that, you know. You have to be in passion with something. Mm-hmm. There are no secrets in life, no? I mean, it has to be something with a lot of passion and details. And then the product is perfect. It's your baby. Mm-hmm. It's your product. And other people, let them know what you are doing. And then if they come close to you and you are afraid of not being number one, then think of something different. Jump ahead. This is, I believe in competition, because if you're alone, you sleep. And if you sleep, you don't make any innovation. I love people knowing exactly what I'm doing in my beds and mattress and all this stuff. So when they come closer, I will wake up and do something different. This is adrenaline. We need that.
Obviously, you're passionate, you love what you do, and that makes the whole difference. When we love doing something, we do it with extra creativity and the je ne sais quoi that is impossible for others to kind of do it exactly the same, because yes, it has our own essence in it.
Yes, I mean, if you, let's say, start making mattresses and beds with the knowledge you got today from COCO-MAT, you make a nice factory, okay? But then I see that you are closing the distance between what you had before getting all this knowledge and when you start producing. And then I will be very awake. I will be very happy to see that somebody is coming closer. Then I have to think of something different. It's not only about the product. It's how you run a shop, how you give the possibility of to somebody to go and test the bed. What is the hospitality when somebody enters the shop? There are so many other different factors. 1,000 details. So, as a matter of fact, I would love other companies to come closer because they give me the pleasure to think a bit more innovative.
Yeah. You respect very much the earth and the planet. For example, I love how you created those little slippers out of pieces that were, that were just extra.
You know, my father used to be a Gastarbeiter in Germany for many, many years. So I know what is sort of crisis, having no food and all this stuff. And even nowadays, when my kids, they don't eat all their food which is on the plate, I don't like that. So I don't like throwing things away. Why? Because things have got energy. I've got a lot of sun hours in there. You know, not only food, but, you know, products like cotton, all this stuff. So you produce. And if your main goal is to make money, you don't care about the rest of the day. But that's not good because you cannot sleep easily if you make money, but you pollute the environment. So all the rest has a meaning. The rest of our beds, let's say the fabrics we use to make eye masks, the rest of our cocoa fiber, we make this sort of nice sleepers. And I remember that lady coming to asking for a job 17, 18 years ago, saying, I need a job and I know that COCO-MAT is a good company. Could I start working? I had zero at that time for her, but I said, wait a minute, I've got a good idea. I had no idea at all, but I knew that somebody from above would help me in order to find something for her, and then I would be feeling very good for myself. And then we thought we have this cocoa fiber pieces that we make the beds, and like Ivo, you know, he's 2.4 meters tall, no? So yes. He needs a longer bed. And what are you going to do with a smaller bed that I need? This extra part, you do a product because it's there. It's a pity. I mean, it's a scene thrown that away. So what you do is, I got a press and I started making this pattern for the shoe business, okay? And then I got some extra stuff from sofas, also cutting little pieces of cloth and fabric. And then we made these beautiful slippers that you tried. Eh? And by the way, you're a tall girl, so you need a bigger size. No, I give it for you, okay?
Thank you. Thank you. And you also hire handicapped people? That's yes, to you, that's not an issue?
It's part of our society. Imagine that you have a son or you have a relative that is like this. Somebody has to help me. It's not. I mean, this society here in Holland is very good because they care, they give money. But apart from that, they must be with us, enjoying our eyes, talking, communicating, dedicate time with them. Then it's very good. And we started a long time ago when a young fellow wanted a job, and he was mentally handicapped. And then I said, come on, we invite him and we let him work in our moving stuff inside COCO-MAT, you know, in the factories. Don't give him any responsibility, big responsibility, because he couldn't understand everything. And we had a guy there, a very good guy, who is still there, but now he's a salesman. He became a salesman after working with disabled kids many years. He had always classical music. He had six people in one place. No everybody was disabled there. And he used to arrange stuff that they process and procedures that they needed only physical presence, you know what I mean, with people that they had a Down syndrome and all this stuff. And all these years he made a great job, and now it's a tradition in COCO-MAT. So all these disabled people, they are with us, and we have something like 25, 26 nowadays working and doing very good work for COCO-MAT, for themselves and for the society, because nobody should be excluded in our society, no?
And so what's your primary intention with everything that you do? Because I know now you're getting into the the bicycles, and you want people to get off their butt and sweat.
Yes, to make people laugh like you, to make people happy. This is the intention. And then if I make you happy, you will make me happy. I don't know how, but you will do one day. So this is the intention, to see people smiling, to see people, you know, enjoying being at COCO-MAT or having a COCO-MAT product, of being related anyhow with COCO-MAT. So I think bike is a beautiful product nowadays for Greece. That's why I want it to be very, very good. Yeah? If possible, to have, you know, even the tires having a flat tire, you know what I mean? That doesn't break and doesn't give you any problems. And then with a very good price, and make it a part of their daily life, to go to their job, coming back, going shopping or whatever. This product is a passion product, you know. I love it, and I'm 100% sure that it's going to be very successful. And then I've got another intention also, because we participate in a company producing olive oil, and I want to make the natural Viagra. What is a natural Viagra? Because I don't know what Viagra is, but anyway, people, they drink it in order to have good sex, what they say. But is that, this is insane, because, I mean, in order to be there, it is your blood that circulates around your body. So if you don't make it as a lifestyle, if you don't drink, let's say, if you don't have honey or olive oil or whatever, which is healthy, then it doesn't matter what you take in order to be a stallion, what they say, is not going to succeed. So we bought this part of this company producing olive oil, and nowadays we are working very hard to produce a shot of 20 ml where you're going to put olive oil, honey, Ipophaes is a wild plant that Alexander the Great used to give to the horses to go from Greece to India at that time, you know, long, long, long journeys to the soldiers. And it's a word that says ipos, hippodrome, you know, is a horse. Phaes, it is shiny. So you take this plant with a lot of antioxidants and a lot of vitamins, and then you become healthy. So I want to put that also in, and we tried already. And then some pomegranate, because it's also very healthy, and some orange juice, and then give it to people when they wake up in the morning, so they take it, and the whole day they feel very powerful, very healthy. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. This is another stuff. All together is to make people laugh, mm-hmm. to make people loving their bodies and being happy.
Yep.
So this is my dream.
What are some of the pitfalls that we can fall into when the business start to grow, and in what you're doing? Is there some things that that we have to just remember and recenter in? Did you have to make some difficult choices sometimes, so that it stays on your value and you still remain?
Of course, always. Even tomorrow, we'll have a decision which was wrong. But I mean, this is not about getting down. It's how to get up. You know, of course, you fall down many, many times in life. And tomorrow, it is another case. Nobody is as wise as saying, as being able to say, listen, I never make mistakes and I will not fall down. Of course, I will fall down with everything I do. But the big pleasure is to come up as soon as you get down. Mm-hmm. So these products, of course, the bike, they have difficulties, and this is missing, and you haven't got any experience. But who can stop being in love with what you're doing? Nobody. Yeah. So there are more solutions than problems, you know. Of course, there will be problems with the drunk I want, with the olive oil, with everything. But if you want to give pleasure to people and to the society, and you want to go to bed every night and you feel, man, I did something very positive, I love it, then there will be plenty of solutions. Okay, so I'm not afraid of making mistakes.
Yeah.
I love my mistakes. I don't repeat them, but you learn. And yeah. Socrates says, I get old and I always learn new things, no?
Yes.
So in business is the same.
Yeah. And what would you like to say to the Greek people watching? Especially the Greek people.
To get a bike and move by bike and drink this shot, which is very good. Honey, olive oil. What was the word? You remember? Ipophaes?
Uh-huh.
That means shiny horses, no? Uh-huh. And pomegranate, natural products, and then they will be happy, laughing, loving their bodies, you know, and that's it. Happiness is inside you. Don't expect anybody to give you happiness, you know. Happiness is the reflection of yourself. So if you're happy yourself, everything will be okay, and no crisis or whatever, because we don't need anything. Not from northern countries, we don't need, you know, money to be sent down there. To do what? to make a swimming pool. No, thank you. I'm going to swim at the seaside, you know. Eh? You want to give me a Fanta or a Coca-Cola? No, I have an orange juice, and that's it. I mean, oranges are there, and nobody buys them anymore. It's incredible, no? I mean, I know people that, because the price is so low, that they let the oranges fall down, and then they go and they buy, you know, a drunk made out of one drop of orange juice. You know what I mean? So.
Well, thank you for this moment. I really hear that you're thriving and that you put a lot of unconditional love in everything you do, and you definitely enjoy it. And I think it's a wonderful example. Thank you.
And I hope to see you in Greece.
Yes.
September, we said.
Yes, okay, in Greece. Welcome. Gotta come to Greece, of course.
Welcome.
much love from Amsterdam.